the great I am, the mighty God you are. Hey, the great, you are body and over shaken, you are the great, the mighty God, the mighty God. Shekeli masoko toli adosa. Hey, the mighty God. Oh, the great, the great, the mighty God. You are. Hey, the great, the great. Sing, sing. Shakata yaba, rekete kemoso. Oh, the great I am, the mighty God you are. Hey, the great, the great, the great, the great, the great you are. The great I am, the mighty God. Somebody help me sing the great, the mighty God you are. Sing the great I am, mighty God, yes you are, yes you are. The great I am, je connais ma la ba 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 ba. Lift up your voice, worship him, worship him. The great I am, you are. The great, the mighty one, you are. Somebody help me worship him for the gift of life, the bread of life we say, yeah, hey, you are. Moment, we worship you, we give you glory, we bless you, yes Lord, who is like unto you, oh the great you are, oh Lord, just worship him, give him praise, reina mosayaros, reach in your hand, worship him, let your voice be heard. Are you grateful? Are you grateful? Makere, Robinados, yeah, 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 yeah. Let us charge the atmosphere. Wake up, wake up. Makota yade, Renonianosa. Lord, we worship you. We bless your name. We bless your name. We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. Almighty God. We say, you are my only God. Hey, no matter what they say. Yes, Lord, when success come my way, I will praise you, Lord. I say, count your blessings, name them one by one. People of God, count your blessings, see what God. Hey, I saw. Count your blessing, number, and it will surprise you. Hey, what a Lord! Rekadosi and the Bregebosha and the Yados Rinadosi. Begin to worship him. Begin to worship him. Perfect sound is restored to you. The power of the Lord is setting the stage. The anointing of God is breaking yoke. It's a new morning. Invoke, make a demand of the healing hand of God, of the precious hand of God to take over your life. In the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. We command right now by the power of the Most High God. We declare your presence is taking over this atmosphere. In the name of God the Father, of God the Son, of God the Holy Spirit, there is a change, there is a power that is at war in my life. In the name. power of the Lord is at work in my life. In the name of Jesus, the hand of God is working in my health. I declare heaven on earth in my health throughout this season. My health is restored like that of an eagle. I declare no infirmity, no affliction, no form of medication will keep me alive. The presence of the Lord, declare by the presence of God. By the presence of God, Jamale Braso Kotaya. In the name of Jesus, every negative medical valley, I command it is turned into a testimony. Today, open your mouth and declare. In the name of Jesus, I declare medical valley that is again supernatural health is turning now. In the name of Jesus, I declare I am healed. I am delivered from every affliction of infirmity. In the name of Jesus, I speak the word of life upon my life today. In the name of Jesus, the presence of God is charging my life. In the name of Jesus, my love is renewed. My strength, you are renewed. You are renewed. I am not permitted to be sick. I am not permitted to be sick. I am not permitted to be afflicted. I declare the joy of the Lord is my strength from today. In the name of Jesus, I declare my day I renew like that of an eagle. In the name of Jesus, I speak the word of life upon my life. I have life. I have life abundantly. I have good health abundantly. I speak the word of life upon my life from today. No power from the pit of hell will be able to afflict me throughout this season. I will not need any form of medication to keep me healthy. Open your mouth and declare, from this day going forward, I will not need any form of medication to keep me healthy. It's a decree. It's a verdict. Open your mouth and pray. Every negative medical body, I overrule it. I declare the book of Job 33:22-25 upon my life. Job 33:23-25 becomes my portion. The Lord will be gracious unto me. In the name of Jesus, I will not go into the grave. In the name of Jesus, the hold of untimely death is broken. Clap your hands and declare. Jacob alerere, Makota laradosha, the hold of untimely death, it is broken. My flesh shall be young like that of a child. In the name of Jesus, Job 33:24-25 becomes my portion all the days of my life. Whatever is not permitted in the heavenly seems to reside in my body. In the name of Jesus, I declare I am raised up together to sit in heavenly place in Christ Jesus. Ephesians 2:8 becomes my portion. Any problem, any sickness that has been injected into this day, into this week, into the rest of the year, into my future, into this season, I defeat you. I defeat you in the name of Jesus. I defeat any sickness that has been injected into this day. I declare in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. I reject it. Any sickness, releasing to today, releasing to this week, releasing to my future, releasing to the rest of the year. I defeated. I am seated in heavenly place in Christ Jesus. I am above sin. I am above affliction. No problem will be injected into my life. I declare any problem that wants to kill, I escape. I am not a victim. I am not a victim. I declare in the name of Jesus, my head will not have evil. I declare in the name of you, every arrow of sickness, you are hindered. You are hindered in my life. I declare affliction of the day, it will not locate me. Pray. We have been praying that prayer since yesterday. Affliction of the day, according to Psalm 91, verse 5. Affliction that flies, sickness of the day. It will not locate me. Lebra sota, makaya de. Open your mouth, pray. Don't be asleep. The hand of God shall be visible over my head. According to Exodus chapter 8, verse 19. The hand of God, pray. He shall be visible. He shall be visible. I proclaim in the name of Jesus, yoke of sickness, yoke of disease, you are destroyed. Enchantment, divination to destroy me. Every divination to inflict sickness, I defeat you by the blood of Jesus. I declare in the name of Jesus, the oil of God is upon my life. I am made whole. In the name of Jesus, get your anointing oil out. Anoint yourself before you go out. I speak the word of God, the anointing of God, in the name of Jesus. By this anointing, I declare healing. By the reason of this anointing, I am delivered from sickness. I speak into this oil today, in the name of Jesus. Whatever is causing sickness in the atmosphere, by this anointing, you are defeated. I am free. Every sin of sickness, I destroy you. Whatever is planted by the devil in any area of my life, I declare you are uprooted. Pray. I declare I am a partaker of a son. I am a partaker of divine health. It's my covenant right. I declare in the name of Jesus, the anointing, the healing river is flowing in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth. Jump into that river now. Yes, Lord. The water is stirred up. The water is stirred up. It's your healing. Your health is coming alive. Receive divine health. Your healing is coming back. Now take it. In the name of Jesus, I declare in the name of Jesus, every sin, every spell, every yoke of sickness upon my life, you are over. You are finally, by this prayer, you are over. Every head concern, every head issue, you are over. In the name of Jesus, today, I declare my escape from sickness, my escape from affliction, my escape from calamity, my escape from the grave. Open your mouth and pray. Yes, that is how we pray. In the name of Jesus, by this anointing, I discharge myself from any sickness. In the name of Jesus, by this anointing, I declare today there is an escape. I declare and I decree every struggle with my hair. I terminate you. My quarter, I decree I am relieved from affliction. Anoint yourself and pray. This is a strategic prayer. Open your mouth. Shake the captivity of sickness. By this anointing, I defeat you. I declare my liberty. I declare my liberation. I declare be mentioned again. With my love, open your mouth and declare. Speak the word. Speak the word. Before this prayer is over, affliction is over now. This day, run it away. Makata, yeah. The Lord is taking over every affliction. You are run away. Before this morning prayer is over, I run you away. My yeah, yeah, yeah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. I run you away. I run you away. I run you away. I declare another of healing upon my life. I declare throughout this season, I am standing in good air. Whatever is in my system that is not of God, Jehovah, flush it out. Flush it out. Open your mouth. Take that oil. Drink a shot of that anointing. Power of the Lord. Power of the Lord. Power of the Lord is flushing it. It's flushing it from your throat to your belly, to your blood, to your water. Take a shot of that anointing on anything that is not of God. The Lord is flushing it out. Flush it out. Flush it out. Flush it out. Flush it out. By your power, by your fire, I declare every day planted in my body by the power of the Lord in this anointing, you are rested. You are rested. Open your mouth, pray, pray. That's the power of God. That's the power of God. That impotency, hey, yeah, 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 yeah. That cancer is arrested now. That blood disease, that genital organ problem is arrested. Any feminine issue, any masculine issue is arrested. Now, in the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. In the name of Jesus, whatever has not been of God that has been planted in your body by this anointing, open your mouth, pray. Fire. Fire, 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 fire is going to you, to your respiratory, cardiovascular, your muscular, your respiratory system. The power of God in your reproductive organ is working now. It's working now in your head, in your eyes, in your stomach. Receive it. Anoint your children. Give them that shot. Anything that is not of God, I flush it out of my body right now. In the name of Jesus, by this anointing, no sickness will escape defeat in my life. In the name of Jesus, every enemy agenda in my body, by this anointing, I neutralize you. I neutralize you. I neutralize you. Pray, pray. Fire, fire. Take that anointing or drink it. Fire, fire. Look at what God is doing. That's the power of God. Shine, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. Allah, 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 Allah. Ino, ino, ino. Aku, aku, aku. Moto. Fire, 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 fire. Ino, ino, ino. Fire, fire in your body, from your head to your soul. I charge you by fire. I charge you by fire. Aku, aku, aku. Allah, 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 Allah. Enough, enough, fire, fire. I don't know what you call fire in your dialect. I want you to shout, enough, enough, fire in your body, in your bone, in your kidney, in your liver, in your stomach, in your shoulder, in your ankle, in your knee. Fire, fire, fire. You are delivered. Motto, motto, aku, enough, 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 enough. Fire of the Holy Ghost, of the Holy Ghost is working now. That's it. Yes, yes, you are delivered. You are delivered. Every agenda of the enemy, I neutralize it. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Stretch your hand. I feel God wants to move right now. Yes. There are long aged problems. Yes, motto. Yes, aku, ino, ola, makotaya. The power of God is working. It's working. It's working. From your head to your toe. Receive the sparks. Receive the spark of that fire. Yeah. Receive it. Yeah. Receive it. Yeah. Fire. Yeah. Fire. Yeah. Fire. Yeah. It's burning now on your toe. Yeah. It's burning now on your feet. Yeah. Yes, now. fire of the Holy Ghost, fire of the Holy Ghost, motto, enough, aku, every disease in your blood, shaka pari tatata. Close your eyes and stretch your hand if you can where you are. I pray today, I make a demand. Every disease that is in your blood, blood-related disease, respiratory-related disease, reproduction-related disease, blood-related disease in your circulatory system, in your respiratory system, yes, 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 in your cardiovascular issue, in your neurological session, in your body, in your womb, any genital organ that is not working, spinal cord, I challenge you in your rib. Now fire, 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 burn out, 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 in the name of Jesus. Anything that is dead in your life, it's receiving life now. It's receiving life. It's receiving life. Everything Jesus died for that you are still lacking, everything Jesus died for that is you are not experiencing, I pray Revelation 5:12 upon you by the power that is in the blood of Jesus. I flush it out of your system. That your eyes is functioning. Remove that glasses. Stretch your face. It's working now. That diabetes is checking now. It's checking. Oh, look at what God is doing. Dry bone is living. Dry bone is living. Dry bone is living. She will not suddenly die. She will not die mysterious death. In the name of Jesus, mysterious sickness, it will not locate you. It will not locate you. Anything that is opposite divine health that is working in your body, according to this Revelation 5:12, I declare in the name of Jesus, by the power in the blood of Jesus, I neutralize it. I neutralize it. I neutralize it. Those things are being arrested by fire, by fire, by fire, by fire. The fire of God is locating any section of your body, any area of your body. Right now, I declare, whatever does not want you to rest by this prayer today, those things are led to rest. I kill those things. Anyone that said you will not use your life in good, I demand their death today, 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 today. We are not here to kill, but there are some things, hear me, that must die for you to live. We will continue that series by the grace of God in the 11th hour. I want you to come. Whatever God needs to kill for you to be at rest, for you to rest, those things must be laid to rest. Yeah. Are you in agreement with me? In the name of Jesus, I make a demand over your life. Today, in the name of Jesus, you are crossing over into health. You are crossing over into divine health. I declare your system is being renewed. In the name of Jesus, I mark your hair. Do you have that oil? Yes, get it. That's it. Put it in your hand. You are going to drink it just from your hand. By the power of the Most High God, I want you to believe God. Believe God in my mouth this morning. By the prophet, they were led out. By the prophet, they were preserved. Listen, God can by itself work healing and deliverance. But when we are under divine instruction, that is how God wants to move. As our pastor used to say, God cannot be caged. What he wants to do is to walk through that your hand. If you don't have anointing oil, you are coming back to take this prayer. Pour a little bit in your hand. I speak today, every mark of sickness that has been programmed, that has been projected into your body, that has been programmed into your system, I declare today, you are released. You are released. You are released. You are released. You that bounded your sickness, I challenge you. I curse you by the God of heaven. Out of these people. Out of these people. Out of their life. Go to their best. Go to their best. Go to their best. They bounded your sickness in your body, in your womb, in your chest. That chest prayer, I command it. Go back. 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 Fire! In the name of Jesus, I declare today, your dominion over sickness, I establish it according to Daniel 7:14. I speak in the name of Jesus Christ, your dominion, your everlasting dominion over any health issue, over any health concern, that menstrual pain irregular, I speak today, that barrenness, that partial blindness, I challenge you by the God of heaven. You are leaving that woman. Amen. You are leaving that man. Amen. In the name of Jesus. That insanity that comes and goes, now I check you out. I check you out. I check you out. I check you out. That health issue now is turned to a testimony. Amen. Drink that oil. Drink that oil in your hand. Yes. Yes. You are Yahweh. Hey. You are Yahweh. You are Yahweh. Hey. You are. You are Yahweh. You are Yahweh. Alpha and Omega, you are Yahweh. Alpha, power of God is working. There is an electric movement now in your body, in your body, in your body, in your body. Receive it, receive it, receive it. That's the power of God. That's the power of God. Enter into your healing. Yes, the water is there. I want you to throw yourself in. Makaya barababa. Masotoya. Yeah, 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 yeah. Renanosa. Omega. You are Yahweh. Ah. Hey. Hey. You are Yahweh. You are Yahweh. Yeah. Look at it. Look at it. Look at that affliction. It's living now. It's living. It's living by the power of God. Receive life. That throat issue. Yes, it's clear. It's clear. It's clear. It's clear. Yes. Omega. You are Yahweh. That's the power of God. It's right in that room now. Yes, that's the presence of God, my sister. Don't joke with it. Don't joke with it. Something that's just come into your body. Close your eyes for a minute. Stretch your hand to this tremor. If you can, that's the hand of God upon you. It's running through you now. Close your eyes. Yes, be quiet where you are. Be quiet. Be silent. That's it. It's there now. The healer is there. The surgeons are there. The heavenly physicians, they are there now. They are performing. Yes, that's it. That's it. Your genital organ, yes, it's been coming back now. It's erecting back. Yes, that's the hand of God upon you. You cannot be blind. I forbid that blindness. Amen. I forbid that sickness. Amen. I forbid that sickness. Amen. I forbid that affliction. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. That insanity is not your portion. Amen. Close your eyes. Yes, that hand is receiving healing. It's receiving healing. Amen. Power of God. Power of God. Amen. I believe in miracle. My sister is walking now. The presence of God. 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 Yes, 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 yes. You are the mighty God. In battle, you are Jehovah. You are the mighty man of war. You are Jehovah. Sing it. You are Jehovah. You are the mighty man in battle. You are Jehovah. Hey. You are the mighty man of war. You are Jehovah. The healing hand of God is resting on you. Yes, sir. Yes, now. Somebody just felt like going to toilet. Another person felt like throwing up there. You feel like coughing. Yes, cough it out. Be still. Be still. Don't sleep, please. Don't sleep. Don't sleep. This is the time that you have been waiting for. This is your divine hospital. It's a divine appointment. The hand of God is working right now. All over 100 people now. Your liberty, your liberation is happening now. Today is that day that the Lord has made for your healing to take place. In the name of Jesus, you are receiving a better life. Anything that is tormenting, anything that is torturing your body, those things are leaving. The sage of sickness is going now. It's going now. It's going now. It's going now. It's going now. Your long-awaited testimony. Yeah. finally is delivered into your hand. It's delivered. It's delivered. You are released from that affliction. You are released from that sickness. In the name of Jesus, you are released now. That's your letter that you are expecting. That's your good news, your letter, your call, your email that you are believing on. Your telephone call is coming through today. Amen. Today. Amen. Today. Amen. Listen and hear me. The latter part of this year, it will be better for you. Amen. Than the beginning. Amen. If you believe it, say three loud amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Say three loud amen. Amen. Yes. One. Amen. Two. Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord is working all over us right now. And I want you to stay in that unction. Don't get out of it. Don't go and do something and be carried away. I want you to carry that presence into your day today, because the Lord has spoken. Every time there is a teaching or the ministration of the word, listen, it is not the preacher. Listen, especially if it is a genuine man or woman of God, the Lord take over. All that he needs is a vessel. And that is why we are available on reaching your heart. It's the one that is streaming in. Listen, the protection of God, the hand of God, the camera of heaven is zooming on you now. It's zooming on you. That affliction is going back. You will be healed. You will be delivered. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. You will not need any medication to keep you healthy again. In the name of Jesus. Amen. We don't kick against medicine. Yes, we don't. Because we believe that medicine is the wisdom of God that has been given to man. Yes, you just add me that. The medicine that you use is the wisdom of God that has been given to man. We don't kick against it. But listen, you will need to be sick for you to use a medication. That's the prayer that I'm praying. In the name that is above every other name, from now, you will not need any form of medicine, any form of prescription, any form of medication. Some people cannot travel. They cannot go anywhere without the bags of their medication. If they leave, that journey is already ruined. They will need to call for it. Listen to me, my brother and my sister. The plan of God for you is for you to live in divine air. He has something in mind when he was creating man. What are you telling me? Adam lived for how many years? 900 years. Wow. Wow. You are just 40. You are just 55. You are just 52. You are just 35. You are just 30. So I'm telling you, the plan and the package of heaven for your life is that you will live beyond your predecessors. You will live beyond your mother. You will live beyond your father. You will live beyond your brother. You will live beyond your sister. By this word is a covenant, yes, that we are establishing. That you will live long. And you will not just live long, you will live in good health. There are some people, when pastor was preaching last Sunday, he said there are people that pray for death to kill them. Are we together? There are people that pray. There are family that pray. Why? Because that person has become a body. They pray that kill death. Come and take them. I'm praying for you today. You will never be bedridden. Amen. You will never be incapacitated. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Sickness will not hold you. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. There are people that want to do things, but sickness has slowed them down. We want to pray in the next session. Anything that must die for you to live, let God let them go and rest now. Any power that is saying you will lose your own life in pain and in agony, it is time for them to travel. Yes, it is time for them to relocate. Are you in agreement with me? Any power that says it is in pain that you will lose your life, I'm telling you, in the next 24 hours, in the next 48 hours, in the next 72 hours, if they will not change, let them be laid to rest. In the name of Jesus. I know what I'm saying, and I know the power of God that is backing this voice up. It is not an ordinary voice that is speaking to you right now. So I declare that prayer. I repeat it again. Any power that is saying you will be in pain, look at me. It is not convenient for you to be in that condition. No, it is not. Heaven forbid you to be sick. So I pray today, any power that is saying you will be in sickness, I pray, let that sickness fall on them. Yeah. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. Luke chapter 5 verse 17, it reads, and it came to pass on a certain day, as he was teaching, that there was Pharisees, there were doctors. The doctors of the law were even there as he was preaching. And listen to what happened. They were sitting down by, which were come from every part of the world. They came from Galilee. They came from Judea. They came from Jerusalem. And whilst the word of God was coming for, the power of God. The power of God. The divine power. power of God. The divine medication, the great physician, his power, yes. His presence, yes, was there to heal everybody. Everybody. I look at the scripture that the Lord gave us in the book of Psalm 103, verse 3 to 5. Psalm 103, verse 3 to 5. It says, who forgive all your iniquity? Who healed all thy disease? Who redeem your life from destruction? Who crown thee with loving kindness and tender mercy? Who satisfy your mouth with good things so that your youth is renewed? Your youth is renewed. The plan of God is for man to be renewed. That was why Adam demonstrated it. I'm telling you, my sister and my brother, that was why the scripture speaking in the book of Psalm 105, go there quickly. Psalm 105, verse 37. Psalm 105, verse 37, which was our anchor scripture where we started this way. I'm praying for you. That same power of God that is ready to heal, that same power of God that is ready to deliver, is at work right now. Yeah. He's at work on this platform. Yeah. In the name of Jesus, the Bible says he brought them forth. You have been brought forth into a new order from this moment. Amen. I'm telling you, you will forget that medication. Amen. We were in a season of fasting and prayer like this, and a baby that was tube fed, not spoon, no, not bottle. It was a tube that this baby was being fed with. And listen, the medical precision, the medical decision of this boy, the medical diagnosis of this boy, people that are from King's Church, they can bear witness because they are living witness. They hear this testimony live and direct from the mother that shared it with us. This boy was being fed through the tube. And listen, the medical verdict is that for life, this will be the condition. But once we are in the season of fasting and prayer, the mother stepped out in faith. She believed God against all odds. The power of God came one morning like this. We were together after the Sunday service. She came and she said, this is the condition. And the Spirit of the Lord moved me. As this woman was speaking to the senior pastor, Pastor Michael, I came in and I was vexed in my spirit. And I told her, the Spirit of God said, I should stay with her in prayer for the next 7 days. And every morning, I was standing in agreement. I was standing, listen, little did we know, this woman forgot completely. It was a time of fasting and prayer like this. Listen, the God of yesterday is the same God of today. He has the power. He can do. I always tell you, he can undo what the enemy has done. I don't know what they have done with your vision. I don't know what they have done with your hearing. I don't know what they have done with your womb. I don't know what they have done with your strength, with your vitality. I don't know what they have done with any part of your health. But I know that from today, in the name of Jesus, listen, the conclusion of that testimony was that that boy, the pharmacy, they begin to call the mother that come and take your medication, because every week they have to order specially this medication for this boy. So the mother was not going for it. The pharmacy, they were calling him. You know how it is in this part of the world. They were calling her, come and take it. Come. And she came. She told us. She said, Pastor, I want to share my testimony. He said, do you know that my son, this is the condition. I have not gone to the pharmacy to collect the medication. He said, I believe God. While we were in these 30 days, that something will happen. And of it did, something happened. This boy that I'm telling you over is over 20 years, has gone to primary, has gone to secondary. He's a boy, he's an adult now. No one day since that day has this boy returned to be fed with a tube. Can I pray for you this morning? I don't know what the medical diagnosis is. I don't know what their decision is. I don't know what their prediction is. But I know that I know the healer. I know the great physician. I know the one that can heal. I know the one that can deliver. I know the one that gives. Divine health is working now. In that case, believe God in our mouth. We are not just here to play lotto like Pastor said yesterday. We are not just here waking up, wasting our time. No. If it is not working, let's pack it up. We know that it is working. We know that it can work. We know God has done it. He's no respecter of person. And what he has done with one, he's able to do with another. In the name of Jesus. The Bible speaking said there is no one feeble person. the young ones, the mothers, the fathers, every one of them, every frame was erected. There was not one skin disease. All their eyes were clear and it was shining. Not one child lost strength. Not one woman lost strength. All the days, the scripture speaking there in the book of Numbers 23:21. I know another girl in our midst. God is doing a lot. And I know the next miracle is starting with you. This was a girl that has sickle cell. I'm telling you, sickle cell anemia is a living testimony. The testifier is still alive today. This girl, the mother will bring her to the hospital for blood transfusion every so often. And I remember one of the incidents. One night, the mother called again and this girl was in pain. I remember going there and leaning down beside the bed of this bed. Of this baby, and we begin to cry and we begin to pray. Listen to me. After that, this girl that I'm telling you about is totally healed, is in the uni now, healed totally. Listen, one day they were performing a surgery. God took this child to heaven. I'm telling you a live testimony. I did not make this up. It's not a third year, it's directly from where it came from. This girl saw a vision. The Jesus came in while that surgery was being performed on her and then change her. When she woke up, she was telling her mother the different things that she saw. For weeks, I even went there, I was talking to her. Listen, the conclusion of the story of that girl was that she was discharged from that sickle cell clinic. That sickle cell torn. They told her, the consultant looked at her file. They canceled it. And they told her, you don't need to return again. You are discharged. The mother sent the letter. This is a testimony that are backed up with a medical report. I'm not just telling you an hearsay. They send a message. They send a letter to clear her that she doesn't need to come to the sickle cell clinic again. Today, you that you are hearing my voice, in the name of Jesus, in your lineage, in your family, there will be no need for medication. Amen. Not again. Amen. After this meeting, in the name of Jesus, no wonder the Bible speaking in Numbers 23:21, it says the dread, the fear of these people, it fell upon the people. The people begin to fear them. They said their strength was like that of a unicorn. God said he will not put the disease. Pastor Michael was expanding on that. Exodus 25:26. He said, I will not put the disease of the Egyptians. There are some diseases that are of the Egyptian. He said, I will not put it on you. He said, because what I am the Lord that healed thee. Exodus 25:26. And he made his word to be good. So as long as you keep the word, that's where I'm closing. As long as you are in obedience, as long as you conform, listen, God has his own path. God has his own path that he will fulfill. We are told that things happen to them that are, for example, in the Old Testament. And it's for us today, for us to learn, for us also to believe that God that has said, he has a better thing. Listen, those people were walking in shadow. They were walking in types. But we are walking in the real substance. The real substance of the Holy Spirit. The real substance of the power of God. The real substance of the healing anointing of the Most High God. Somebody shout hallelujah. So I know, according to a word in the book of Proverbs chapter 4 verse 22, he said, my word shall be held unto their flesh. What are you going to do? Number one, obey what the Lord has said. Run and get a soul. Run and get somebody on this platform. What did he say in completion of this word? Proverbs 4:22. He said, For they are life unto those that find them, and health unto their flesh. When you feed on the word, health come back to you. Healing come back to you. Look for scriptures like this today. Feed on it. And I'm telling you, your healing will begin to come. He also told us in the book of Malachi chapter 3 verse 6. He also said, we have Christ and with the fulfillment of his promises. I am the Lord. I change it not. He's the same like he did with the Egyptians. He can still make your Egyptian to drown in Red Sea. He make the children of Israel to become fearful before the Egyptian. He makes the Egyptian to become afraid. He put the dread of the Egyptians, of the Israelites. Yes, he put it upon them. he put it upon them. That the Egyptian will see the Israelite and they will be afraid. Wow. Egyptians are sickness. From today, the mark of the Lord upon you in the name of Jesus. People celebrating birthday, congratulations. Wow. God will bless you. With good health, the Lord will satisfy you. People celebrating anniversary, congratulations to you. I want to give an opportunity to somebody to give their life to Jesus. Your health begins to go into divine order when you give your life to Jesus Christ. With Him on your side, you are signing up for a divine health. That's why I want you to make up your mind today that there is no any other God I will serve. There is no any other person I will go to other than Jesus. Because listen, He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. As you trust in Him and you give your life to Him, ask Him to forgive your sin. Ask Him to come and live with you. There is a number scrolling right now. Send your name to us so that we can continue to pray with you. Send your prayer request also, and the Lord will bless you and cause His face to shine upon you. The Lord has asked us to send this program to people, 20 people. Today is day 15. The fasting and prayer has just gotten to the middle. I'm telling you, this is the good part of it. Yes, we just begin to glide in the middle now. Yes, in the name of Jesus, and swelling with a new strength. I don't want you to miss it. If you have not been fasting, please, please, I want to beg you, make sure that today you make a time to be in the presence of the Lord with a fast. The breaking time is 3 p.m. We're going to be back again for the 3 doses. This is one. We're coming back for the second round, which is from 11 to 12. And then we'll be back again for the 6:30 communion service, where the man of God will be ministering powerfully. I don't want you to miss. It's a new order. What God is doing with this program this year is new. People on this program that have been with us over 10 years, they can testify. Every year has not been the same. And I know God has signed up your name in this testifier for this year. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I'll see you back shortly. Before then, make sure that you send this program to somebody. God bless you in Jesus' name. Amen.